We are going to start with information gathering techniques. Now, before we start with information gathering technique, this is basically one of the important phases of penetration testing or hacking process. Now, penetration testing and ethical hackers are basically using this information gathering techniques process to improve the security of the network, or we may say the systems, by fixing the vulnerabilities which are being found during testing and defending the systems from attacks by malicious users, or we can say the hackers. Whereas on the other hand, the hackers are basically using the same methods and techniques without the permission of the authorized person for the purpose of misusing this information. So this information gathering technique is one of the process or one of the phases of hacking, which we'll be understanding. But before that, we'll be first seeing what all other phases are there. This, I hope everyone is able to see my screen, phases of hacking. Now here we have five phases of hacking. Number one is reconnaissance. Number two is scanning and enumeration. Number three, gaining access. Next, maintaining access and clearing tracks. Now, these are the five important phases of hacking, which is being used either by the hackers or the penetration testers. Now, what reconnaissance is? Basically, this is the first phase where a hacker tries to collect the information about the target. It is also known as the preparatory phase, or we can say the information gathering phase, where the hacker tries to collect information, maximum information about the target. Whereas the second one is scanning and enumeration. In this particular phase, the attacker begins to actively probe a target machine or maybe the network for the vulnerabilities existing, which he can exploit. Now, there are multiple tools used for this kind of phase. That means we can use Nessus, we can use Nexpose, or we can also use Nmap for this. The third one is your gaining access. This is the third phase where an attacker tries to break into the system, network, or maybe the applications, again using multiple automated tools or methods, and then tries to escalate the user privileges to control the systems which are connected to it. Now, in this process, the hackers or the penetration testers try to locate the vulnerability and try to exploit it in order to enter into the system. Now, again, there are tools for this. The primary tool, if I want to name it, there is Metasploit, which is basically been used for gaining the access to a particular machine or to a target. Then we have maintaining access. So after the penetration tester gains the access to a particular target or to a particular machine, the hacker then installs certain backdoors, maybe like your trojans, rootkits, or any other malicious file, in order to enter to that particular system whenever he needs access to that particular system. So here, basically, the attacker is trying to maintain the access for future purpose. So here the objective is to maintain the access to that particular target until he finishes the task which he planned to accomplish for that particular system. Again, Metasploit is the preferred tool in this particular process. Then we have the last phase known as clearing tracks. Here the hacker tries to clear all those evidences so that no traces should be identified at a later point of time. This mainly involves your modifying, corrupting, deleting the values of logs, maybe modifying the registry values, uninstalling or deleting the applications folders which he has created while gaining the access or maintaining the access. So this is basically to clear the cache, cookies, the log files, and all those various folders which he has created. So this is the five phases of hacking, which is being used either by the penetration tester to identify the security posture of that particular target machine, or maybe by the hacker to misuse the information. Now we'll be talking about explicitly on the first part or the first phase, that is reconnaissance or the information gathering phase. Now, what is reconnaissance information gathering? How this is being done? What all tools are, what are, what we can say, the websites which are being helping us to perform this information gathering on the target or the reconnaissance on the target? What is information gathering? So information gathering is the process of collecting as much information as possible from different sources about any company, about any individual, organization, or any of the target group. So here, basically, the hacker tries to collect data on the security posture and tries to reduce the focus area. Now, when I say reducing the focus area, that means finding out the specific IP addresses, maybe identifying the vulnerabilities within the target system, or maybe drawing a kind of diagram, which may be said as network map or network diagram, which will exactly help the hacker to break into the system easily. So it basically provides your important information like your domain name, your TCP, UDP services, which is being used by the target, the username, the system names, passwords, and many other things. So here, what we are doing, we are trying to gather more and more information about the target machine. And this can be done multiple using multiple tools. We have Maltego, we have LinkedIn, Facebook, Google, Twitter, and so many social media sites are also there which help us to actually get the data or get the information about the target. Now, here, when I talk about reconnaissance, there are two ways actually to gather the information. One is your active reconnaissance, second is your passive reconnaissance. When I say active reconnaissance, this is basically directly interacting with the target to gather information. So here we are actually asking the target itself to get the information about its own. Now here we are using Nmap tool for getting the information about the target itself. We have eyewitness tool also we are using for that. DNS recon tool is also we are using for that to gather information about the target. Whereas when we talk about passive reconnaissance, this is basically here we are trying to collect the information about the target without directly accessing the target itself. So we are gathering the information from different sources, right? So here we are trying to collect the information maybe from social media, maybe public websites, and many other you can say open source tools which help us to give the information or provide the information about the target without directly interacting with it. So here we have Social Mapper is one of the Ocean social media mapping tool. Then there is your, as I told you, have multiple social media websites like LinkedIn, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, Google+. So these are some of the websites which help us to gather the information about that particular target. There's one bit nice tool known as the Harvester, which is actually gathering the information about a particular target by providing the subdomain names, email addresses, and many other things. So we'll be seeing few of the tools in the demonstration part. So in this particular reconnaissance and your information gathering phase, generally the penetration testers, or we can say the hackers, are trying to get the network details, trying to get domain information, what all ports are open, what all services are being there, server details, web server version, misconfiguration if the target is using anything. Then it also tries to gather Windows permission, user information, group information, what all files have permissions which are weak, which can be exploited, what all background running processes are there, and maybe website URL crawling. So there are many information which can be taken care, which can be taken by the attackers or the penetration testers during this particular process, or we can say the phase. So now what we are going to do, we are going to divide the entire techniques into various parts. So there is multiple techniques to gather this information, maybe using active reconnaissance techniques or maybe using passive reconnaissance techniques. So here we will try to gather more and more information using passive reconnaissance. There we have Google Docs, we have social networks, so search engines, we have domain names, social engineering techniques through which we are able to get more and more information about a particular target. Now, if we can see this particular slide, where what all users are doing and what all information they are posting, and from that information, what attackers are actually gaining. This is what this particular slide is showing to you all. So generally what people do, people maintain their profiles, and also very regularly they are updating their status. Now when the people are maintaining their profiles, they are actually posting the information about the photo, about their contact numbers, their email addresses, date of birth, location, and work details. And while they're updating their status, they're actually posting most recent personal information, their location, their family and friends information, their activities and interests, technology-related information, upcoming events information, where they're going to join, and all those things. So when they are posting all these information on the internet, then the attackers tries to gain the information from that particular sources itself. So they try to get the personal information about the target, including their personal information, photographs, or maybe they are also going to get the information through social engineering techniques. Other than that, they're also trying to get the information about the platform which a particular target is using, what technologies they are using. If they are using the technology, they will try to identify the vulnerabilities in that technology so that they can exploit it at the later stage. Then what is the target location? How many employees are there? Then the by these many number of information gathering techniques and can be used for exploitation purpose. Now let's move to this. Various techniques which will help us to gather the information about a particular target. The first technique which we are going to use it is Google Docs. Now, when I say Google Docs, maybe few of you have heard about this, where Google Docking or Google Hacking is basically is one technique which returns the information that is difficult to locate through simple search queries. So this is a search string that uses advanced search operators to find information that is not readily available on a website. So it includes that information which is not intended for public viewing, but also that is not being adequately protected. So if it is not protected, but it is not being intended for public viewing, still the hackers or the penetration testers are able to get that information using simple search queries on Google. And that is what is known as Google Docking or Google Hacking. So this is basically the practice of using Google to find your vulnerable web applications and maybe the servers by using your Google search queries or using Google search engine capabilities, and then trying to get lot of data which is not protected. Now, what all data can we find using Google Docs? When I say we can use Google Docs, we can even identify or we can find it out administration login pages. You can find it out username and passwords, vulnerable entities, sensitive documents, government military data, maybe email lists, bank account details, and many more other things. So while using Google Docs, if these things are not protected properly, then the hackers can very easily get all these information using Google Docking. Now, Google Docking is a passive attack method. As we discussed, there are two types of methods. So Google Docking is a passive attack method. So it may return your multiple information, like as we have discussed, usernames, passwords, your email list, your sensitive documents, your vulnerabilities, government military data, and all from the internet. Now, there are multiple operators which we are using it for Google Docs. Now, what are those operators? There are a long list of, lengthy list of these operators. We'll be talking about few operators here. And then we'll be discussing, we'll be providing you one link where you can just go through that and can see what all other operators can be used using Google Docking. So here we have in title, we have in URL, in text, site, and many other operators for that. When we say in title is basically one of the operators, search string operator, which is allowing a hacker to search for the pages with specific text in their HTML title. So maybe you have seen when you are searching a particular page, a title is being specified to each and every page. So it will match with that title and return you all those pages which are having the same title mentioned in this in title operator. For example, if I write it down in title colon double quotes login dot or login page. So when I'm saying login page, it will find it out all those various HTML titles matching with login page and it will return me all the URLs for that. Then we have in URL. In URL allows a hacker to search for the pages based on the text contained in the URL. For example, if I write it down in URL colon login.php, so it will provide me all the pages which has a login.php mentioned in its URL. So you'll be seeing the demonstration of the same as well. Then we have in text. Now, when I say in text, this operator basically searches the entire content of a given page for the keywords which we supply it with in text. So if I say in text colon username, so it will find it out all the pages where username as a text is being mentioned. Then we have site. Site is basically an operator which limits the scope of a query to a single website. If I need to search something in cdag.in website, I can limit the scope of my search while mentioning this operator as site. So I can say site colon cdag.in. So it will limit the scope of my query to that particular website itself. Other than that, we have file type, we have extension, we can also use wildcard characters sort of thing. We have cache and many other things, many other operators. Even you can club one or two operators as well. So you can have multiple operators in a single search string and based on that, it is going to provide you the results. So if we can see a few of these operators, so we have in URL, we already have discussed site, file type is basically taking the extension. Then we have all in URL, it searches for all the words in the URL, then only it returns you the result. Then we have in text that we have discussed, related. This is basically, we find out the results from the website which are related to that particular search item. And so many are there. So with these, we are going to identify the results based on the search string, based on the query which we are mentioning, as well as which are actually vulnerable. For example, if I take it in this manner, where we have in URL colon product.php question mark ID. Now this in URL is an operator which we are using it. Then this is the search string which we want, the criteria which we want to be selected. Now, what does it mean? That all the URLs which is being extracted should have this particular text in the URL, product.php question mark ID. Now here, if you see the results, we are getting this much of results. And here we see product.php question mark ID is equal to. Then here, products.php question mark ID. And in each and every result, we'll be getting this as a part of the URL. Similarly, we are going to get lot many details. Next, if you can see, we have one operator known as extension here. So extension basically checks the extension file, so it will retrieve the extension SQL where the text should be username and password. Now here you can see, here we have the text, whatever text is being written, it is going to check it from here, and the extension of the file should be SQL. So here the file is SQL and the text is username and password. Here also we can see the extension is SQL and we have username and password here. All the results which you are going to get it is actually the extension SQL, and username and password will be as a part of the text in that URL which we are going to get it. So without wasting much more time and discussing theoretical part, let's move to the demonstration of the same. We will show how Google Docking works. 3 to 4 examples we are going to show it to you, and then we will discuss other part of the same. So other information gathering techniques are also there. So let me first show you the demonstration of Google Docking, and then we'll be talking about the other information gathering techniques. So I have with me Mr. Divyansh, who is going to show you the demonstration. So one information gathering technique we are going to talk about, and then we are going to show you the demonstration of the same. So Divyansh, firstly, could you please share your screen and discuss 4 to 5 examples of Google Docs?
Yes, ma'am. So as ma'am told us about the working of Google Docs, there are 4 basic types of queries that we can use to basically enhance our searches. So Google Docs first query that was mentioned was in URL. So in URL colon helps to find out pages that we want to find that are vulnerable to the particular system. So a website may consist of multiple pages, and in URL is used to basically find out the particular page that we want to find. So if I write in URL colon login.php, I would be able to find pages that would have login.php in it. So that means if I right click and open it a new open this particular result in a new tab, I may have a particular page that is similar to login.php. That means it was able to find out a login.php page in this particular URL, and the results that we are getting here inside this particular results of Google, we are able to get multiple results that have login.php file inside of their particular URL. So this is how we will be able to use in URL colon login.php. So in URL basically finding out the particular string that you want to find in a particular URL. Next particular query is in text. So if I write in text .php or in text admin and press enter. So why I'm writing in text colon admin? So in text is basically a query that is used to basically find out whatever a written string that we want to find, such as enter login detail, admin panel login username password. So this is basically giving us a summary that there is an admin panel inside of it. So if I wrote in text admin or in text CDAT, we would be able to find out whatever string that we have want to, like in text colon CDAC means that we want to find out a particular page that has CDAC written on it. So that means the particular page that that has CDAC written on its particular summary will be showcased here. So we have in text colon CDAC, and many multiple searches that we are getting in this particular Google search, we are getting everything that is written with a word that is CDAC. So CDAC's whole results will be demonstrated here. So this is how we are able to use in text. Let's move to the next one, that is so site is basically the query that is being used to basically gather all of the particular information regarding CDAC. So if I write CDAC site colon CDAC, I would be able to find every results that is result that is directed to CDAC. So that means we will be able to get the CDAC's main website. We'll be able to get the wiki page for CDAC. We'll be able to get a LinkedIn page of CDAC and CDACnetwork.org. So whatever string that we will find in front of a site, we'll be able to get the information of it. So this is how you will be using a site query. Let's move to the next one, that is in title. So the in title query is used to basically gather all the results that have the title written as something like admin or login or anything. So in title will search for the particular result. such as this. If you are able to see the particular title area of our particular tab, we are able to see in title admin. That means this is the result that we are we want to basically get. So this is the title area. So if I write in title colon admin, I would be able to get pages that will have, wait a sec. I will be able to get pages that will have title or admin written on their title area. So this is how we will be able to use in title query also. So we will be able to gather pages that has admin or anything written on their title area. So this is how you use in title. So these are the basic examples of the four basic examples of queries of Google Docs that can be used during the practical. I have other examples also that are complex. Let me also use those examples. One of the examples is of other queries that we can use to find out information. Let me type this. So this is file type colon XLS index colon India. So if I'm able to search this query, this means file type, meaning you can say that like it can be related to your PPT, your docs, or your Excel sheet. So that means I'm going to find out a particular file which is currently linked to India. So Intex India will be directing all those results that have India on it, and it will be saved in a particular XLS or Excel sheet format. So as you are able to see, every result that we are getting is related to your Excel sheet, and we can basically download and see the particular results inside. So this is one of the complex queries that you can use for searching your particular results. So let me also use one of more advanced queries fastly. So this one is your extension colon SQL index colon username index colon password. That means I want to find a particular file that is saved in a .sql format which has index username and index password written in it. So this will also lead me to the particular results that will have username password inside of it and will also be saved in the .sql format. So if we see one of the files or one of the search results from them, you would be able to find their username and password also. So this is one of the queries that you can use to basically gather some of the information, or even a information gathering attack, a particular hacker is able to get the information through it. So there are multiple queries also. Let me search one of the most prominent queries that we go for. Let me also use this particular query known as Intel colon webcam XP5. So this particular query help us to find out pages that are linked to a particular CCTV cameras. So that means these pages will not be publicly available if you type you want live webcams. These pages would be available if you are able to use Google Docs. So you would be able to find webcams or CCTV cameras that are basically linked to your internet and that are not authenticated with the username password. So you might be able to see one of them live on this particular web browser. So let this particular website open. And we will open one more login. So these type of websites consist of live webcams that you can basically see from your particular browser. Okay, let me open one more. Okay, so as you can see, this is a live webcam footage of a particular website. So if I wrote in title colon webcam XP5, I would be able to get results of all the live webcams or CCTVs that are basically not authenticated and are publicly available on the internet. And as you can see, we are able to open one of them and we are able to see a live footage. We'll also go to the next one. This is also a live footage which consists of the date, that is today's date, 19th January 2021, along with the date of 9/4/41. That means it's a morning there, and we are able to see a live footage. So this is how you are able to use particularly your particular Google Docs to find out the accurate information that you need, even the live webcams and all that are not authenticated. So as you are able to see, we are able to see this particular live footage through these queries. So you are able to see or basically gather any of the results through Google Docs. If you are able to use it, the four basic one also, you might be able to find something interesting that is available on it.
Yeah, that's fine, Divyansh. Thank you.
Yeah.
So if you are interested in getting more data, more operators or search strings, then you can just go to this particular URL, that is exploitdb.com. So if you are going to go to this particular URL, you'll be getting a lot of Google hacking database, and you can see what all advanced operators are being used by the hackers to gather information. Now let's move to the next part. Now with the Google Dockings, we have seen that few of the information can be collected, right? Now, once that information is being collected, we are going to note it down somewhere, and then we'll be moving to the next technique or the tool to identify the information. Very basic information which we can get it from Whois as well. So Whois basically our internet record listing, which identifies who owns a domain and how to get in contact with them. So you will get some information from this Whois as well. You can simply go to www.whois.com, which actually is being used for querying the databases that store the registered users or assignees of an internet resource, such as your domain name, your IP address, blog, autonomous system, and etc. And this will help you out to get the information about a particular target. Now, in some of the cases, it will not provide you the IP address. If it is not providing the IP address of a particular target, you can even use your one particular command on typing CMD. So there, while going to start, run, and then write it down CMD there, and then you will be opening a command prompt. There you can simply type a command tracer, that is trace RT, and then you can maybe write it down the target there. Once you are pressing enter, you'll be getting the IP address on the top. So from there also, you can get the IP address of a particular target as well. So we'll be showing you how this is being done. Once you are able to get the target IP address, much information, you can also have another tool known as onif. Now if you type onif.io, so this is one of the URL which will provide you the details about the IP address, the SYN scan, and many other more information about that target. So this is again a good resource for getting the information or gathering the information about a particular target. So we'll be seeing the demonstration of this also, and we'll find it out in what all information this ONIF is providing it to us. Then we have one more information profiler tool known as Built With. Now the goal of this particular website Built With is to help the web developers, researchers, and designers who have actually started their job of development, maybe of research and designing, you can say very fastly. That means those developers who want to see that what all other organizations or what all other industries are actually using the technologies, what all servers they are using, what all web structure they are using, that all information can very easily be identified by Built With. So this has been created with a very nice objective, but the hackers are now using it for their malicious purposes. So what they do, they actually try to gather the information related to the technology, related to the frameworks, related to the web services which is being used by that particular target using this Built With. Now when we type this builtwith.com, this is the home page which you are going to get it. Here you can just write it down the name of the target which you want know the details about. So for example, we have inserted cdag.in here and clicked on that lookup button. Now when we are clicking on it, it's going to provide me the details divided into multiple tabs. Now here you can see we have technology profile, we have technology profile, metadata profile, relationship profile, and redirect profile. When we say the technology profile, it is going to provide me the details related to the technology, the Google Analytics, which is being used. It also provides me the details about the frameworks, which is being used by this particular target, whatever target you have searched with, built with. It will also provide me the library, JavaScript libraries and functions, which is being used. And also, it is going to provide me the details related to the dates as well. If I want the dates to be also mentioned, I can just click on detailed technology profile. And even you can go to these various analytics and tracking links, and you can get more detail about this particular feature. So detailed technology profile allows the hacker or the penetration tester to enter into each and every point which is being mentioned here, and then get a detailed understanding of what all is being used by this particular target. Other than that, if you can see here, as I told, it is mentioning you the frameworks as well. So what language, programming language is being used, right? What all JavaScript libraries and functions is being used, what date it has been updated. So all those information is again very crucial for the hacker to get that. Now, in some of the cases, you can also get certain subdomains from this particular built with as well. What all subdomains is being used by that particular target? So here you can get a list of subdomains as well. You can get EasyDNS, your SSL certificates details, the web servers which is being used by this, even the operating systems and servers also which is being used by this particular target or this particular website. So it is providing you much more information about a particular target, and that is what hackers are also doing the same thing. Now, if you click on relationship profile, it gives you the tag history also. And based on this tag history, it will provide you who, what all sites, websites, or what all domains are actually being connected with this particular tag, this particular ID. So that also you can just see, it will be showing you the demonstration of the same, and will show you that once we are going to put our mouse pointer here, over a mouse pointer here, it will select all those various connected websites and tell us what all connected website or what all websites are actually connected with this particular tag ID. Then it will give the list of all the connected websites as well. So with this built with, you will be able to, or an attacker or a penetration tester will be able to get a lot of information about the target. So we will be now showing you the demonstration of your who is. Then we'll be also showing you how we can get the IP address through Trace RT. And then we'll be moving towards your built with. So this is how we are going to show that how the data is being, or the information is being gathered by the hacker. So let me show you the demonstration of the same. Please open the screen. So first, who is, then Trace RT, then ONIF, and then built with.
Okay. So as Matt told us about the demonstration of who is ONIF and built with, I will. So let me who is and press enter. So everyone knows that there's also a built-in function. Wait.
Devansh, your voice is not coming. Divyansh?
Hello, am I audible?
Yeah.
So as we all know about whois, as it already been discussed in the Linux also, that you have this whois command that you can use to basically check out the websites. So we'll be opening one of the links through here. So we'll type whois in your Google search engine, and we'll go on the onto the first search result that we get of whois.com. So whois.com is basically used to find out the information about the particular domain or the online website that has that particular domain. So we'll write ctac.in and we'll just click on search. Okay, so this is for the domain registration. Wait.
So we'll type just... it on the right corner. Whois.com.
I think this will be okay, ma'am. Or whois.com. Oh no, ma'am. This is basically for the domain searching. So let me just open this one. So this is whois. You can go for who.is and just we'll write here the domain name and we'll just search for it. So it will try to gather the information about this particular website. So as you can see, we are able to get the similar domains. Whose data country honorable? Let's check. Okay, so what we are able to get is that some of the information, I think some of the information of this of our website is basically private and we are not able to see it. So let me click on the DNS records. We are able to see the particular DNS records that this particular website or domain has. So as you can see, the particular records of type SOA, NS, name servers, and your A records and AAA records are being mentioned here. So these are all the particular records or the DNS records that our particular domain would have. And these are all of the information that you will be able to gather from who.is website. So this, let me also click on the diagnostics if we can get some information. Okay, for that you have to complete the captcha. So it will be able to and trace the particular domain also. And you are able to see the same similar function that are done in the Linux system are also being done here. So we get some of the information related to our particular domain inside this particular website of who.is. So we are able to scan our particular website through who.is website. So let's also move to the next one, that is onif.io. For that, you have to write onif.io or just press here and we to get the first result for it of onif cyber defense search engine. We'll click on it, right click on it and just see. So this particular website is able to gather information. So here we can write straight away ctac.in and click on search. Okay, for this you have to go to another web request register for a free account. I think for this you need to basically click on for a free account. Let me see if we can do this. Okay.
Divyansh, that's fine. Onif.io, anyone can see it. Now we can move to build
it. Yes, ma'am. So I think for that you need to register, and it is similar to our built with a combination with the whois website. So let's go with built with. So this particular website, as ma'am told us that a particular developer, website developer, can basically use this website to gather some information about this about some certain websites that he has looked into it. So as you can see, built with technology here, what you have to go is like search the particular built with in the Google search engine. just click or right click on this particular thing. Result that you find with Bilbit Technology Lookup, and then go to this particular website. Here you have to just type in ctag.in and click on the lookup. So ctag.in, the particular domain, whole information related to this particular website will be given in this particular technology profile, along with the other columns also, such as detailed technology profile, the metadata profile, the relationship profile, and the redirect profile. So in the technology profile, as you can see, one domain information of ctag.in will be given. So our particular website, all of the technologies, all of the third-party applications will be, whole information will be given in this particular builtit.com. A basic summary also, like analytics and tracking, whatever analytics and track applications that we are using, such as Google Analytics, Google Analysis, Analytics Classic, Google Universal Analytics, and Global Site Tag will be mentioned in the analytics and tracking. Similar third parties that we use to basically up the searches of a particular website. Then we go to widgets, which will have Google Tag Manager and COVID-19 options. And then we go to the frameworks as ASP.NET that we are using .NET framework. So for the mobile, we are using Viewport Meta, iPhone/mobile compatible. It can be opened in the particular mobile also frame also. Then we got the JavaScript libraries and functions with the respond tag of GitHub. And then we got the careers links. And also the name server is EasyDNS, and the SPF or email hosting provider has the SPF usage statistics and the SSL certificates of GeoTrust, SSL, SSL by default, DigiCert, RapidSSL. We got the web servers of IIS, and we got the IPv6 enabled OSs and servers, and Google Webmasters. As you can see, when I clicked on the particular technology profile, we are getting only the information about the ctag.in with multiple DigiCerts and all. Well, basically, it is a combined information of all the subdomains that this particular ctag.in has. So you are getting the whole technology profile of all of the subdomains along with the main domains and all of the domains which will have these pair of technologies. But when I click on the detailed technology profile, the detailed technology profile will give us in a much more detailed way. That means ctag.in will have the analytics and tracking. Okay, the first one that we are able to find a technology profile, the same detail with differentiating every other subdomains with it. That means if we are able to get ctag.in, the first detected, last detected column, in first detected and last detected column, along with the analytics and tracking, we are able to see all of the information from the technology profile. We go to widgets, we get the Google Tag Manager, the COVID-19, Adobe Connect, WebEx panel, workplace by Facebook, ReCAPTCHA, Google Custom Search, frameworks, .NET, .NET 4.0, PHP, the CDN, the Content Delivery Network, GStatic, Microsoft, mobile and all. You are able to see the JavaScript also. And then when we go to the downward side, we are able to see ctag.in/start. That means all of the pages which have different technologies in our particular website. When we go downward more, we are able to see rtws.ctag.in. This is basically a subdomain of ctag.in that have also a different type of application that it is using with the web servers of Apache, Tomcat, Coyote, and Apache. Then we go a little bit downward. We are able to see the subdomain of hcdc.ctag.in that also some of the information related to Apache web servers. Then we go eSign, then we go FCAT, then we go ICT-IPR, BioInfo, MedInfo, FCAT and all. So all of the information related to our website or the particular website, which all of the things that it has through subdomains, all of the technologies that these subdomains have will be mentioned in this particular builtwith.com in the detailed technology profile. So the technology profile would be a summary of it, and the detailed technology profile would be the detailed information related to the subdomains and whatever text they are using. So when we go and click on the metadata profile, it is basically a summary, or I should say the summary of which of the company name and their address and all. So for this, you can go for login or sign up for free. Well, we don't need that. Let's go for this also, we need CAPTCHA. So when coming to the relationship profile, so what relationship profile is basically what type of Google tag systems that you are using. So this UA is basically the Google tag system that was enabled in January 2011 and last detected on March. So this Google tag site UA is being used by certain organizations such as cdac.org.in, cdac Chennai, cdac Hyderabad, cdac India and .com. So they are basically using this. So it is able to see and tell us that connected websites to this particular tag is basically highlighted in your orange feed and you are able to see them. When you go to the next one, that is GTM UA, that is basically also another tag that has been used by other websites like amravati.gov.in, appsbook.in and cca.gov.in. So we get the particular tag that whoever websites are using this particular both tags have been mentioned like in the highlighted way. Let's go and click on the redirect profile. So when you see the domain, the cdac.in all inbound redirects. So that means our website cdac.in would have a particular link that will be redirecting you to the cdachyderabad.in website. So this is also been mentioned on the redirect profile that we have in this particular built this application. So this is basically a demo that that if combined with Whois and Onif will also give the results same as built with, and we are able to see all of the subword information that we can also find on the subdomain scanner also inside this particular built with website. Ma'am.
Yeah. So now we have seen how the information is being gathered through built with, through Whois and through Google Docking mainly. Now let's move to the few of the browser extensions which help us to again get more information about the particular target. What all that information is, let's see that. The first browser extension which we are going to demonstrate you and discuss is known as Netcraft. Now this Netcraft is basically a tool which allow us to look up for the information relating to the site which we are visiting and opening on the browser. So this is a browser extension which provides the protection from phishing and malicious JavaScript as well. So this is a browser extension which helps the user also to protect themselves from these phishing and malicious JavaScript type attacks. And even this is also useful for the hackers and the penetration testers to get the information about the site which we are visiting. So what all information it is going to get, it is going to provide, let's see that. So first, what all features this Netcraft has? Number one, it provides you the detailed site reports. That is what I said, it is going to provide you the complete report of the site which you are actually accessing. Then it will provide you the risk rating as well based on the ratings which is being given to that particular site which you are trying to use it. It will also help you to conveniently report that particular website if you suspect that it has phishing and fraudulent sites. It will provide you the protection against cross-site scripting type of attacks. So basically, this Netcraft extension traps this cross-site scripting attacks and other suspicious URLs which will contain your characters which may highly likely to be deceived. So based on that, it will provide you a warning that this site may have cross-site scripting kind of malicious files. Then it will provide you protection against phishing sites as well as malicious JavaScript. So this is useful for the end users as well. Also, it is useful for the hackers, the penetration testers. So now let's see how this Netcraft is being used. We are going to select one of the vulnerable website that already we have selected it through Google Docs. If you remember this one product.php ? ID, we have used it using Google Docs, and we have identified one website which is vulnerable. This is the website which we are going to now check it with Netcraft. So how to install this Netcraft? Very easy. You have to open Google and you have to type it there, Netcraft extension. Once you type there, Netcraft extension, the first link which you are going to get it, that you have to click, and then it will ask you to add it to the browser. So it is available for all the browsers. Whatever browser you are using, you can add this extension to that browser. So we are using Chrome, for example. So we have added it to Chrome. So click on that Add to Chrome button. and then it will be added to your browser with this logo that is N. Now, whatever website you are going to open, you just click on this logo N, and you'll be getting a very brief report about that particular website which is being opened by the user. Here, this is the name of that particular website. This is the country or the site rank, the URL of the website which we have opened and all. Now, if you want a detailed report of this particular website, just click on this link. Either go to site report or go to coda.cc. And then you'll be getting a detailed report of that particular website. Here you can see the risk rating as well. It is showing green. That means there is no risk rating informed to this Netcraft about this particular website. Now, when I click on this detailed report, it will provide me the complete report of that particular website with the background information, the network information, the hosting history information, and many other things. So here you can see the site title, the site rank, the keywords and all. Here, this is the network information, the site, the domain, the IP address, the IPv6 address. It is not present here, but if you are using some other website or some other target, it may have this particular information. Hosting country is there. What is the, who is the net block owner, name server of that particular target, and the hosting history as well. When I'm going to go beyond that particular information, it is going to provide me the hosting history. Here you can see, here we have net block owner, IP address, the operating system which is being used, what is the web server which is being used, and also the last seen part. So when this particular information is being seen, so hosting history and network information, lot of this information is being gathered by this Netcraft, and this can be taken by the hacker, and then they try to misuse it. They try to see, gather more and more information about this IP address. Maybe they can find it out that which web server they are using, and then maybe in future we'll be doing some more tools. They may tell us about the versions which is being used by this particular web server, and from that particular web server and its version, very easily I can go to Google and search it for the vulnerabilities of that particular web server. If I'm able to get the vulnerabilities of that version of web server, I can very easily exploit that also. So these are the information gathering tools which generally the penetration tester and hacker is actually trying to use it. We'll be seeing the demonstration of the same, but for that, let's move to one another extension, or you can say a website, which is known as Shodan. Now, Shodan is basically a popular OSINT tool. When I say OSINT, OSINT is open source intelligence tool, which is specifically designed for internet connected devices. So it gives you information which we have taken it, or which we have gathered it from previous tools. Even it also tells us, or provides me some more information related to who is owning that particular IP, what all other services and ports are open, and lot many other things. So basically, as you can see on the slide, it is telling you that Shodan plugin tells you where the website is hosted, country, city, who owns the IP. So these two information, we can very easily get it from Netcraft as well. Also, you can cross-check the details from Netcraft and Shodan. And then it also tells you additionally what all other services and ports are open for that particular target. And this will help the attacker to actually exploit that particular service or port. So here we have this plugin also as a browser extension. Also, you can have a website, shodan.io, and there also you can go and you can search it out for that particular target. Now, let's again take the same vulnerable website, and we'll be scanning this through Shodan and getting the information more and more about this particular website. So how to install this Shodan? Again, very simple. You have to open Google, write it down there, Shodan extension, and then you can just click on the first link and click on Add to Chrome. Now, when you click on Add to Chrome, it will be added to the browser with this particular logo. That is three bubbles here, you can see. Now, whatever website you are going to open, Just click on this particular logo of Shodan, and it is going to provide you some brief information about that particular target, including the IP address, the details, the country, city, organization, and then the list of ports which are actually being opened. Here you can see ATN 443 is open. Along with that, 21, 22, 465, 995 and other ports are also open. Now, if you want to get more details about this particular target, you can just click on this view host details. Now, when you are clicking on this view host details, it will provide you the information, the detailed information about the services which is being used, the web technologies which is being used by this particular target, and some other information. Here you can see the information related to the city, country, ISP and all, but the number of ports which are open, the services which are being open, and few of the websites are so vulnerable that they're also trying to tell you the versions of these services as well. And very easily you can go to Google and just search it for those services. Along with versions, you'll be getting a lot of vulnerabilities if it has. Then web technologies, it is going to provide you the details. This is the network information. This is the web technologies information. This is basically your services which are being used by this particular target. And very importantly, it tells you about the list of vulnerabilities which are also present in that particular website or in that particular target. So it gives you the vulnerabilities along with the CVE number. If you want to gather more information about this CVE, you can just copy this CVE, go to Google and paste it there. You'll be getting a lot of information about that CVE. What does the CVE mean? What this vulnerability is? How to exploit this vulnerability? And even how this vulnerability can be overcome. So this is good for developers. This is good for end users, as well as this tool is good for hackers and penetration testers as well. So this is how Shodan actually works. So now let's see one more tool known as RobTex. And when I say RobTex, RobTex is basically again one another information gathering tool, which gathers the information related to IP number, domain names, host names, autonomous systems, the routes which is being used, etc. So this is basically a tool which is an ocean tool which gathered information from different sources, and it indexes that particular data in a big database and then provide the free access to the data to the user who is using actually this RobTex. So this RobTex is basically being used for gathering information with very easy steps, where you can just open this robtex.com. Here you will be getting a text field where you can write it down, the host name, the IP number, root or RIS number. Let's click on that, put cdag.in and just press enter. You'll be getting the details about that particular target in the form of these tabs. Now you can click on each and every tab and you can get a lot of information about the target which you have mentioned here. So you can go to analysis, then you can go to quick info, and you'll be getting a lot of information. So you will be getting, if we are pressing analysis, you'll be getting the name servers, the CDAC mail servers, what all mail servers is being used, IP numbers are being used, what all results which can be found. Then if you click on the next tab, that was quick info, you can even get the details related to the domain, the registry, the name servers which are being used, and not many other things. These are basically the links. When you click on this, you'll be getting more and more information about it. The mail servers also, when you click on this, you'll be getting more and more information about it. So let's see the demonstration of these first, and then only we'll be moving further. I'll stop sharing my screen and asking Divyansh to just share his screen and demonstrate the various tools which we have discussed just now. So what all we have discussed, we have started with, I think, Netcraft extension. Then we have discussed Shodan, and after that we discussed RobTex. So these are the three tools which we are going to demonstrate right now. Please, Divyansh.
Yes, ma'am. So as Ma'am told us that how to install Netgraph, let me also give you a demo. Netgraph extension and then Chrome. So we write Netgraph extension Chrome in the Google search field. So when we'll just press enter, we would be able to find this particular extension here. Just open in a new tab, and this will be redirecting you to the particular Chrome web store. So this particular Netgraph extension is available in your Chrome web store, and you can basically click on add to Chrome. Here I've already added, and it is available on the top right corner of my screen as Netgraph extension. So you can add this particular extension from Chrome web store, and you will be able to see the overview that this is a particular comprehensive site information and protection from phishing and malicious JavaScript when browsing the web. So it is basically helping you out to gather the information of a website, as well as helping you to protect yourself from phishing attacks. So you can click on this add to Chrome button here, and you will be able to download this particular extension. So let's move to the next part, that is how to use a Netgraph extension. So it is simple. You just need to go to a particular site. So we will be going to the CDAG website, the main website, and then we will be using the particular extension. This is the particular site of CDAG, and you are able to see the main website page. So here, what we have to do is like, go to the top right corner of your screen and click on Netgraph. And you will be able to see the particular prompt of Netgraph. So it gives us the CDAG.in main URL along with the Indian flag. That is, this is an Indian website. The site report, the risk rating, and you get a particular health bar. So this is basically the bar of risk rating, that if it is zero, that means it's good. And if when it will be one or two, you'll get a red marker like a health bar, which will be shown here. So this is an okay website because of risk rating zero. Country India, site ranking has been given. The first seen March 2009, hosted by CDAG itself. So you are able to get it, and you can, even if there's a particular malicious website, you can basically report the malicious URL through here also. So let's click on the site report, and another tab will be open, which will be redirecting us to Netgraph website, which has sitereport.netgraph.com/?url=? Our particular URL. So what it does is like, it tries to gather the information about our website, like such as CDAG. Let this particular website load. Okay. Should not be retrieved. Let me check again. So if you are not able to gather the information, let me check why. Okay. So if it is not able to do it, then we can move to the next one. There's other website that we can also check, such as product.php. Let's go for this and this. Let's also click on this site report. Okay, now why? So it's not a problem. I think I have other website. I think they is down. That's why we are not able to gather the information through Netgraph. So let me also check if Netgraph main server is down. So Netgraph extension basically gives you information of any of the website. If you go there and just click on Netgraph and click on site report. So maybe their server is down. That's why we are not able to get the information. And then I will go for the search button, search Netgraph, and just click CDAG and just search for it. So they also give you that you can use their particular browser and email and mobile extensions that they have. Search another keyword. Search this. Okay, so I think their services are a little bit down. That's why we are not able to get it. So this site contains automatic search. Okay, so we will be able to find out less information that that you are all able to see in the particular website of in the PPD. So here you can basically find out everything from the DNS patterns or host names matching with cdac.in and every other information that they have. We needed CDAC's main one. Okay, they have their information. We'll click this. Okay, then we get redirected. We need the resources. Yes, site to boot. We want to look up information here. Let's check here. Okay, so I think the extensions, there's some problem with the extension. So this is how we'll be able to do it. We'll just go to Netcraft website here without the extension, and we'll go and click on the site report. And simply we have to write the cdac.in website's name, and we will be able to get a site report from here. So we are able to get the background report, which is consists of site title and all that has been done by us, and the site ranking and description along with the date first seen. So our main motive or our hacker's motive will also go to the network part, that we have the site, the URL name, the domain cdac.in, netblock owner, hosting company, and more important, the IPv4 address that we have along with the virus total button. Well, you can check our website for any of the malicious content which it does not have. That's why the virus total link has been given to us. If you click on it, you will be able to check our website with it. Then we got the IPv4 autonomous systems ID, that is AS554433, and IPv6 address is also enabled with us along with this autonomous system. Reverse DNS organization, DNS admin and all. So we get all of the information of top level domain also, that is India. And then we get the IP delegation where our particular website can be accessed from any of the other countries IPs also. So the IP delegation has also been given in our particular website. We go to SSL TLS, that has to be like we have switched it off. This is not an HTTP site, it will not tell you because of that. Then we got the hosting history, we got multiple IPs, multiple servers, and our web server is basically unknown from the latest one. So we get the sender policy framework, then we got the DMRC, then we got the web trackers, that is also off. So we get a lot of or simple, if your website is protected, you will get a less information from their particular organization. And some of the information will be available on the Netcraft, as because Netcraft is a very old organization of which was founded in 1995. And they are basically helping out people to get to the original websites rather than to the fake ones. And that's how they are able to basically protect, by giving you information that this website is a original website rather than a fake one. Oh, okay. So we're able to get the information of cdac.in from our extensions as well as from our particular Netcraft website. Just go and click on the site report or DNS. You can do anything. Just click on site report and enter the name, and you would be able to go to that website. Even this particular extension that we were using can also be used for it. Just click on the site report or cdac.in. You will be transferred to this particular area without any problem, and you would be able to see the particular data. So let's move to the next one. That is our Shodan. So let us type Shodan, the similar one, extension, then Chrome, and press enter. So Shodan is also a particular extension that can be used, open in a new link tab, and you will be redirected to Shodan. is also available on the Chrome Web Store, where you can basically add to Chrome and it will be directly installed in your particular Chrome browser. This is also a plugin tells you where the website is hosted, who owns the IP, and what other services or slash ports are open. It is basically your nmap available on the online websites. So what we have to do is like go to Shodan, click on add to Chrome, and it will be installed. And then we'll move to a particular website that is also CDAC. So we are already on CDAC. So let's go on to the top right corner of our screen and click on Shodan. So this particular information is similar to the particular one that we are able to find in Nitra. That means this is an original information that we are giving to the public site. We have got our URL, IP address, host name, country, city, and organization, and also that what port we are currently using. That is 443 for the HTTPS protocol. We'll click on view host detail and we'll be able to find a lot of information about our website. But if it is a protected website, there will be a less information rather than the unprotected websites that do not know what cybersecurity really is. So we get the IP address, the general information, and what hosting domain, country, organization, ISP, and ISN number of IPv4 address. And the web technology that we use are Bootstrap, jQuery, and Microsoft.NET. So some information is there, but not a lot, because this is a particular protected website. You get the open ports like 443. Then you get what 443 request or response from the particular website is. So that means you would be able to see, let me also zoom in. You are able to see what HTTP version we are using, 200 OK. That means this particular website is on. You get the extreme options, set cookies and all, but you don't get a lot of information. If it was an unprotected website, you would have gotten it. And I've got one example to basically show you with that. Let me see if that example is on. OK. So I'll be quickly showing you this and we'll be moving on. So this is a particular website. If you see, if you have seen the PPT, you might be able to see all of the things such as the information that it is showing, similar thing that it popped up. We'll go to view host detail just quickly and we'll see same IP, country, city of this particular website and all the information along with the web technologies. But here you are able to see three port numbers, 80443 and 8001, and we'll get the information of each one. So this is Apache server that you are using along with the HTTPD service and this version. So if the particular website is showing you the version, that means it will have some vulnerabilities that can be searched on the internet, and even Shodan will give you that so that you have to protect it from it. Even some of the information of server like Apache's version, the OpenSSL version, the PHP version have been given by this website on the internet. Let's go to the 443 also, same similar functions. The HTTPD version is also available, like 2.4.6, the particular server name, the OpenSSL and the PHP versions, and you are able to see much of the information rather than the protected one. So if you compare both the websites, you will get less information here because it's a protected one, and this you get a lot of information just by seeing the particular response from this particular website in the Shodan area. And also there's another tab that is open up of vulnerabilities, and as you can see there are many CVEs that is available on this particular website along with the 2014 find out CVE of 0117, that is mod_proxy module, that has some vulnerability along with the version. So there are multiple CVEs that you are able to see inside this particular website on in Shodan. So there are multiple CVEs that a particular hacker would be able to find out. If you search on the internet, would be able to see the public payloads and will try to basically enter this particular website to gain the particular admin access, and basically will try to hack the website. So this is what Shodan can also do, as well as protect, as well as also give a particular information regarding the vulnerabilities that it has to safeguard it, as well as it will give the vulnerabilities to the hacker to basically attack on this particular website. So this is how Shodan is used to basically carry information as well as save it and also attack it. So you are able to see two reports. One is the protected one and one is basically the vulnerable one. So this is how basically Shodan is used to basically attack and defend the particular website. So let's move to the next one, that was RobTex. Let me open RobText. So you have to just enter RobText, and the first link that will be available to you will be of robtext.com. Just open this particular website, and the RobText is also, so RobText is a website that is used to basically find out the information about a particular website or domain. So it's used for various kinds of research of IP numbers, domain names, and what it does is like sources to gather public information about IP number, domain names, host name, autonomous system, and routers, etc. So we'll type cdac.in on the search field and click on go. And it will give us a lot of columns such as analysis, quick info, reverse, records, SEO, WOT, Alexa, threat miner, shared graph history, who is GSN, BL, graph old. So as you click on analysis, you will be redirected to the analysis part, which will show us that CDAC has three name servers, two mail servers, and two IP numbers. The EasyDNS name servers are DNS1, DNS2, and DNS3. The CDAC mail server, MX1, MX4. The IP numbers of IPv6 as well as the IPv4 will be given, like point to the remote server of the IP number CDAC, like it is pointed to CDAC.in. Then the results also found there are multiple domain names similar to CDAC. CDAC.b is of some other country, this is some other country, CA.com, FR France, Info, IT, and many other domain top level domain names has been found similar to CDAC. Then you get the quick info, similar, the fully qualified domain name is CDAC.in, the host name, the domain name, registry of India, TLD is also India, IP numbers, the names of the mail servers. So you are able to see a lot of information that is gathered inside RobText, and you will be able to see like a collected information about this particular website. It will give you a lot of information that where it is located, with along with the IPv6 and the IPv4 addressing, along with the AS number, and also some information related to our mail servers. So the SEO also, that the search engine optimization will also tell you the number. It is not big one, but our main would be the quick info and the analysis part. So here we will be able to find out, along with the records, that this IP, this mail server is related to this IP and all. So you get basically a network mapping of this particular website. So there are a lot of information that you can gather from RobText also. So this is just a basic example of how you can use a RobText to find the particular information about the website, ma'am.
So there were so many websites and tools which actually help us to gather information about a particular target, and that is what the hackers and the penetration testers are actually doing. So they are actually giving us the proof of identifying more information about a particular target. Now, if the hacker is not able to get any kind of vulnerability to the from that particular tools which we have discussed, then what they do, they try to identify the subdomains of that particular target, and then try to identify more and more information about those subdomains, and then try to enter from that particular route. So if they are not able to enter to the to that particular target from the main route, then they try to identify the subdomains, alternate routes to enter to that particular target, and then they try to enter and then try to exploit that vulnerability. So for that, there are a few subdomains scanners as well, which help us to provide the details about the alternate ways, alternate paths, or maybe the list of subdomains through which the hacker may enter to the exploit the vulnerabilities if it has. So for that, there is, as I told, there are multiple subdomain scanners. One of the subdomain scanner is findsubdomains.com. This is one of the website which is basically designed to find the subdomains. We'll be trying, if you just write it down in Google, subdomain scanner, we'll be getting a lot of URLs which will help you to identify the subdomains of any of the target. We'll be using one of the URL known as spice.com. Now, when you click on this spice.com, you will be getting this kind of home page where it will ask you to just provide the domain name. Now, when we are providing this domain name, it is going to provide you a detailed list of subdomains. And for each subdomain, it is also going to provide you the additional information about that. Here, if you can see, there are multiple subdomains. For each subdomain, the mail servers and all is going to provide you the IP address and all. also it is going to provide some additional information. So if you can just drag the particular button, that means if you are going through the complete details of this SPICE, which it is providing regarding that particular target, you'll be getting a lot of information about the subdomains and the subdomain internal information. So how many ASINs have been found out, how many IPs have been in CIDR, organization name, and many more other things you'll be able to get it. We will be showing you all those details. Other than that, there is one more digital archive through which you can get a lot of information about the target. This is how the hackers are actually gathering the information, then preparing a network map or a network diagram. And these information help that attacker or the hacker to actually enter into the system, gain the access to the machine, and also try to maintain the access to that particular machine. So here there is one more, maybe you have heard about this digital archive of www, which was founded by Internet Archive, known as Wayback Machine. This is basically allowing the user to go back in that particular, in a particular time period, and then see that what all features that website has, what all information that website provides at that time, and how the website looks like in the past. So for that, you can just go to this particular link, archive.org web, and here you are going to just select or pass it on the target website for which you want the information to be gathered, and also the year from the calendar, and then you'll be getting the very similar image of that particular target at that time period. So that is what Wayback Machine actually provides you, and it also provides you what all information, what all features that particular website has, or what that particular website supports or delivers at that particular calendar year. So here, this is the home page of that archive.org Wayback Machine. Here you can just provide the target or the URL for which you want the information to be retrieved. Just click on this browse history, and you'll be getting the information based on a calendar year. So let's suppose we have passed it on cdac.in. Now here you can see the calendar. Here you can just get it. Just click on any of the calendar year, and you'll be getting a lot of information when that particular, the snapshots have been taken, when that particular website has been changed, what how the website looks like at this particular date. So just you hover your mouse pointer there on this green colored circle, and then you'll be getting that there were two snapshots on this particular date has been taken by this particular website. And if you want to see that snapshot, just click on this time period. You'll be able to see the snapshot of that particular website. So very similarly, we have other options also, like collections, changes, summary, and sitemap as well. So we can click on any of these, and you can get more and more information about it. When we are clicking on that collection part, then also it is going to give me month-wise how it is being changed. Just click on this particular blue part. We'll be getting information what is being done in this. You can also compare the changes, how it was in maybe 1999 and how it is now looking in 2020. So that changes or that comparison also, you can make it very easily with this Wayback Machine. You can get what it was previously, how it is now, so that all information you can get it, latest updates and all. So this also helps to get some of the information about that particular website related to that target. So this also helps the hacker or the penetration testers to get the information about. Now, with this, I have one more OSINT tool which I need to refer today. I have time, I think. So I will be talking about one more tool known as Spiderfoot. Now, this is Spiderfoot HX is one of the tool which actually collects the information from various different, gives you a complete result for that particular target. Now, this is again an OSINT tool, open source tool, which provides you a lot of information about the target, and it collects the information from Have I Been Pwned, Security Trail, Shodan, and many other websites which we have discussed. So this Spiderfoot is basically a reconnaissance tool, that is information gathering tool. Also, it gives you an idea about the investigation for a particular target, perimeter monitoring, that you can get it from here. Just type on Google Spiderfoot HX, and this is what the main homepage you are going to get. This is Spiderfoot HX, which is a reconnaissance tool used for investigations and perimeter monitoring. This is a tool which asks you to provide your email ID, and then it asks you to change the password, and then only you can use this Spiderfoot. What is the reason behind asking this email ID is that it is actually allowing to find out the information about the target, only three targets at a time with one email ID. So if you are providing your email ID and registering with that email ID, you are only allowed to get the information of only three targets with a single email ID. So that is why they are asking you to provide your email ID. Now, generally when these kind of tools are there, we don't email IDs, and then you can just work it out with this. Now, once we are providing this email ID, this is a temporary email ID. Of this particular email ID and registering it with this Spiderfoot, it allows us to create a new scan. Now, when I'm clicking on this create a new scan, it will ask me that which particular website you need to scan. Maybe we can provide first, it is going to provide, ask me what is the name of that scan or the information which you want to get. So we are going to pass it on that name to that information gathering. So maybe we can put it as test 1, 2, 3 and whatever the name. Then you can pass it on the target, but the target which you are going to pass it on should be the domain which you need to check, and then you click on this run scan now. Now, once you click on this run scan now, it will start the gathering of that particular website. It will gather a lot of information about that website and gives you a complete detail about the target. So here it will tell you what all data elements it has checked, data elements, what are errors it has identified, and also it is going to provide you a graph with corresponding to the data elements which it is able to identify, right? So this is still running. The screenshot has been taken when it was still running, and now here you see this has been aborted with these many number of information. So this is what all information it is to you related to that particular target. Now, if you want to see what all information it has, what all data it is going to extract from that particular website, you just go to this particular tab that is Browse By. Click on this Browse By, so arrow is being given here. Just click on this. The first type which it is going to get is data, Browse By data. So whenever you click on this Browse By, you are going to get Browse By data. Just click on that, and here you are going to get the detailed information with respect to the data types. Now here you see the first column is risky, which is going to tell you that what all risky portion it is able to identify from the target. So this is the red box which will tell you that this is the risky part. If you want to see all the risky parts on the top, you can just put it in the descending manner. Just click, double click on this risky part. It will be moved to the descending manner, and then you will be getting all that information related to this data type. Just click on that data type which has a risky part, that is the red box there, and you'll be getting a lot of information about that particular website. So this is how we are actually collecting the information as a penetration tester, or also the hackers are collecting the information about a particular target. So there are lot many other websites. Again, it's impossible to discuss all those various websites at one go. But these are some of the good resources from where the data is being, the information is being collected, and then maybe used by the penetration testers to secure the security posture of the organization, or maybe used by the hackers to exploit it and then misuse it. So let's see the demonstration of these two resources. One is your subdomain scanner and second is your Spiderfoot, which will finish our part as well. So just a moment, please. So now we will first see your Wayback Machine, spice.com, that is subdomain scanner, and then we will see this Spiderfoot.
So as ma'am told us about subdomain scanner, then the Wayback Machine, then the Spiderfoot, we'll be first going to the subdomain scanner. So here we'll write subdomain scanner spice. So in this subdomain finder, you have to just click on the first link of the spice.com website. And in this subdomain finder, spice domain, so in subdomain here, as it is written, use the spice subdomain finder in order to make your reconnaissance process faster and effortless. So here, how to find it? Write subdomain scanner spice in the Google search domain. Click search and go to the first link of subdomain finder. Here, you just have to write CDAC or any of the domain names and click on search. So as we saw in the graph also that we are able to find the subdomains, that function or functionality is also given by spice domain or spice.com to basically crawl every subdomains that this particular website has. You can even customize that particular domain system also. So let's find out what type of subdomains we are able to get through. Let's click on the overview button located at the left corner of your screen, or you can just search for the subdomain. So let's see the subdomains part for cdac.in. Here we are able to find out there are 83 results of subdomains that you are able to find out in cdac.in, but mainly which are closely related to CDAC or are the subdomains of CDAC are econf, Career Indian Air Force, Samhar, and eSign. We are able to see that these four websites are okay. The big site title has also been mentioned along with the Alexa rank and the DNSA records of all the IP addresses that are related to us in this particular manner. So let's also click on the overview button. So in the overview, we get the information about our website, the website IP URL, the organization name, along with the DNS records, with the IDs, and also the security score that is 100. When we go to the downside, we are able to see the DNS history, the security score, the technologies that are used for the web framework, the UI frameworks, and the web servers, along with the JavaScript libraries. So the crawl results, we have the 9 HTTPS. Crawl results, we have 9 HTTP headers, 5 meta tags, 1 cookies, and 3 CSS source path with 31 links and 8 JS source paths. So we are also getting the JS source path that this particular website is currently using. And we get that star.cdac.in and cdac.in linked to us. And even the issuer DN and the subject DN with it. So we get that a lot of information about our website are available on spice.com, which has that there are IOLI systems which are linked to our CDAC career, somehow in eSign. You can also go to the overview and just go to the same domains with different suffixes also part. Here also will be the results that are related to CDAC, basically CDAC of other countries. So you get the CDAC behavioral healthcare dotting of CDAC info, CDAC dev, CDAC.com.au. For other results, you basically have to log into this particular website. But whatever information that we are able to get through the overview, the information that is in the overview part will be able to give us some of the insights of our particular websites linked with some other websites that we can basically see. So our website is linked with the four main domains that were mentioned here. And these are the websites that you can basically see that are linked to our particular website, cdac.in. So if a hacker is not able to get into the main site of cdac.in, he might be able to search other websites or the subdomains that are related to our website, and will try to basically get inside it through the vulnerabilities that he is able to find through Shodan or any of the passive or active scans, and will be able to search vulnerabilities and get inside the server. So if they are shared, if this is a shared website or a shared server, they might be able to get inside one of the websites easily. So these are all the information that you will be able to find through spies. Let's move to the next part, that was Wayback Machines. So Wayback Machine is basically a very great hacking tool. Let's click on Wayback Machine or hacking tool. Or I think from this, you are able to gather information about the websites when they were first created to the way they are updated in each year. So let's click Wayback Machine, search Wayback Machine from the Google search query, and click on the Wayback Machine first link. So you will be redirected to a website or archive.org/web. And this particular website would have a whole internet archive, which consists of all of the websites, or I should say all of the websites information or the way how they look during that particular time. So if I write cdac.in, or if you write any of the websites such as cdac.in and just click on browse history, to try to search all of the websites that were of CDAC of that particular domain, and you would be able to, you are basically given a particular timeline or timestamp. You can see from 1998 to 2021, these columns will show you that the dark columns, that this particular website was saved this many times in this year, then this will be shown here. So whatever updates they have done in this year till from 2005, since 2005 to 2021, it will be shown here with the blocks, with the black blocks that has been given here. So let's click on to 2005, and then we'll be given a particular date calendar where this particular websites were open. So April 2005, the particular website was shown as this. So we'll just click on this in a new link, and we'll just see on April how this particular website looked. So what the hacker will do is, like, he will try to gather information that how this website looked, and he can even do a particular scanning through this archive also if they have saved the particular websites in its full content. So you are able to see this website was first loaded in this year, and it had this many information. Or like a little bit, like I think the website was created at that point of time, and it has a little bit information about this or about our organization. So you are able to see the website when it was created at that point of time. Let's go to a much more prominent time. Let's go to December 2005, and let's take whatever snapshots this particular machine has taken. Let's see how our website looked at December 2005. So this is how our website. After 5-6 years, 10 months, after 10 months, it looked like this. And a hacker would basically try to see whatever inputs that they have. So the Wayback Machine can be used by anyone, even the hackers or developers or anyone who has to see whatever information the particular website had at that point of time. So you are able to see a lot of information if you go to the latest years. Let's go to the latest years and try to see the snapshot from here. The particular developer or the hacker would see that there are so many changes that were done on the CDAC website, and the hacker or the particular developer might be able to see some gaps in their particular application or a waypoint inside of their application. If it compares the particular new versions of the website to the old versions, because even if you update a particular website with some features and all, it might have a waypoint or a particular entry that is basically not hidden in the new versions, but it's still there. Like they have hidden it in some other ways, but there is still attached to this particular website. So the hacker might be able to find the differences using the Wayback Machine. But as you can see, we are able to see the latest pages. It is a little bit different to the way it was created since 2005. So this is how you can, or anyone can use the particular Wayback Machine to gather some information about your websites, how it looked, how it is in the future, or how is it in this particular year, present year. So this is basically your Wayback Machine. Let's move to the next part, that was Spiderfoot HX. So for Spiderfoot HX, there are steps to basically enable that feature. So Spiderfoot also has this way of entering. So that means if I write Spiderfoot HX here, and HX and press enter, I will be redirected to this website. It's an OSINT, a type of scanner. Open this in a new tab. Here you have to enter your email ID. So for this, I might not be using my original email ID. I will be using a temporary mail ID. And I'll create a particular temporary mail for quick access for this particular website. It takes a lot of time. So let the particular temporary email load. So it has loaded this temporary email. I will try to use this email to basically enter myself in this particular website. And this, click next. We check Spiderfoot HX. Okay, so they have updated site. Let me just access it. Okay. So we'll be using on one of these. Let me check. Paste this particular URL and we'll just click on next. Submitted. Okay. We'll just see if the particular mail will arrive here. So maybe they are using, let me check. Okay, so maybe services are down. I'm not able to get the particular link. So basically OSINT is also used to basically scan your whole website so that you are able to gather all of the information that they have on in a passive way, and all of the information that are basically available on all of the internet. And they basically gather all of the information related to your domain inside a particular area where you are able to check each one of that information, such as and the PPT as ma'am mentioned. I think maybe their services are down. Yes, sir.
Divyansh, we can even show that OSINTframework.com so that everyone could go to that particular website and can check it out on their own, that what all OSINT tools are available for extracting the information and maybe doing some other tasks. So we have OSINTframework.com. So this OSINTframework.com is basically a website which provides you a lot of information about tools. Now here you can just click on any of this and you'll be getting a lot of information. See, username, email address. If you want to identify email address of a particular target, then you can click on that and you'll be getting many more other links. So if you can see here, this is a colored one, blue colored word, and a blank one. So if you click on that blue colored one, it means that it will have more tools there. If you are clicking on that, yeah. So here you can see now this name check is basically one of the tool which you can find it out more information about. So this is one of the good website which everyone is advised to use, and kindly check it out, each and every tool here, and see what is this tool actually doing or giving you the information about. So with this, I think we reach to the end of this session. And if there are any questions, we are open to it. Thank you, everyone. Any questions? We are open to it. I hope there is no question regarding this information gathering. Still, if you have, just pass it on to PMU. We will like to answer all these queries, whatever you have. Thank you all. Thank you very much. You all were a great audience and listening very patiently to us. Thank you. Thank you once again. Thank you, PMU. Is Naresh there?
Yeah, I'm here.